occasionally I've made a conscious decision to make a head choice, and it's never worked out for me.
This is what rich, entitled people do when threatened. They conceal the ugly truths to protect themselves.
So we'll get straight to it. I absolutely love The Undoing. I watched the first 6 episodes in a day. Not the first 5, and I've still got one to go. I haven't watched the last one, so I don't know what happened.
You're the only person who's seen the 6th episode.
No, I haven't seen it. Oh, and it's killing me. It just leaves you asking so many questions. I think the biggest one for me was, what would you do if you were Grace? I kept on asking myself that. I kept on saying, would I forgive? Would I be on Jonathan's side for the sake of the son, or because, you know, you still love him a bit? And I guess it's that case of going with your heart over your head, and your head over your heart. What would you do? Do you go with your head or your heart?
In general?
Yeah.
I tend to go with my heart. Occasionally I've made a conscious decision to make a head choice, and it's never worked out for me. But I think for me, my heart, it always kind of, it always is like the truest indicator of the thing that, you know, I'm going to choose. I think that's the other thing. Like, we spend so much time trying to make decisions, even though I think if we get really quiet with ourselves, whether it's our head or our heart, we kind of know what we're going to choose. And it's just like a matter of time before we just admit what our choice is going to be. But yeah, I don't know what I would do in her. I think it would, I don't know.
It's a really tough one. I think that's the biggest question that comes up.
Murder is ugly business. I must warn you, whatever you've heard, it's worse than you think.
Your daughter is hiding something.
You think you can handle everything on your own? This is bigger than you.
You play Grace's best friend, the only mum, the school mum, who sticks by her throughout all of this. I feel like you and Nicole Kidman got on well. Am I right?
We really did. I said earlier, you know, there was such a feeling of just a real kindred spirit, and I felt it so immediately with her, and I knew that sort of artistically I was bound to have a wonderful experience. But I think the thing that I will carry with me is just the sort of human experience and that feeling of that bond that we were able to have quite quickly. It's just rare. It's just rare, and it's so beautiful, and it's something that you sort of want to guard when you meet someone that you feel instantly safe with. I had it with Susanna as well, where I just felt so safe with these two women right away. And that was, it was sort of wonderful, because in this world, there's very little safety. And I think that Sylvia does not get to feel safe really in any of her relationships, other than her relationship with Grace ultimately, you know. And even that one, it's a hard one. Friendship. So yeah, that's a very long answer to say that yes, I really loved her.
What a cast. I mean, to be working with Nicole and then Hugh Grant, who's just hilarious, Donald Sutherland.
Heaven. And Donald is heaven. Donald, yeah, he's someone who had, he and my mother were quite close, and they had worked together, and it was really, it meant so much to me to sort of have, to get to work with him on this and spend time with him. And you know, he's someone that I've really stayed in touch with, and he's amazing. He's really one of the greatest actors we have, and Hugh is just divine beyond words, and such a tremendously great actor. What a brilliant actor, and a very funny human being.
You speak of ugliness. You have not yet met ugliness.
People hire me to create muck.
You just kept hitting and hitting.
You blow fire!
You stay away from my family.
Ah!
crazy people do crazy things.
It's just the perfect binge. From the moment you watch the first episode, you're hooked and you have to keep watching. I happily did it in a day, and I'm sure that's what most people will do because they just need to know what's going to happen. What's the last thing that you binged like that?
I recently watched I May Destroy You.
Oh, yes.
Have you seen it?
It's incredible.
I really thought it was one of the greatest things I've ever seen and or will ever see in my life. I think about it every day. I loved it so much. So that's sort of the one that comes straight to mind. I never wanted it to end.
No. Have you watched Ratched yet?
Sarah is one of my dearest friends on the planet, and I'm two episodes in. I have a baby, so it's taking a little longer. I think normally I would have just watched it all in a day, but I just can't do that right now. But also I'm kind of glad that my life is keeping me from, because I have it to continue to look forward to.
You have to savor it, I think, as well. I think it's one of those ones, it's worth savoring just because it's so stylistic and beautiful.
So beautiful. Look at, and she's so wonderful. And Ryan is someone that I love so much too. And so I have more to go. Don't give anything away.
No, I won't. And finally, we've got so much to look forward to in 2021, not least, hopefully, the next season of American Horror Story. How are you feeling about that? You're all back, aren't you? You and Sarah and Evan and Finn Wittrock, everyone's back.
Yes, I'm very excited to be back, and I'm really looking forward to it. I can't wait.
Can you feel the buzz, the excitement for it to come back?
Yes, I can. Gosh, we have the most incredible fans on that show. They're just they're so amazing, and I can feel it. And I'm in Canada right now, and I can feel it. Everywhere you go, you feel it. It's they're incredible fans. I'm excited. I can't tell you anything, but I'm excited.
I know. You're like, please don't ask me anymore.
Well, you'll just get a sort of blank stare.
Well, it will be worth waiting for. And as you say, you know, we'll get rid of 2020 and into 2021.
That's right.
Thank you so much, Lily. It's been an
absolute pleasure. Thank you so much. So lovely to be here.